It is the Flow Friday Night Sports Show, and let's have a look at what's happening in Northern Areas footy. They've got the Nutrient Ag Solutions Cup this weekend down at Port Broughton, I believe, and the great Graham Spud Mackay is too busy for such things. He's got a $1 billion crop to put in. How are you, Spud? You going all right, mate?
Yeah, I'm going well, thanks, Jason. Well, I wouldn't say that... It's certainly a lot. I know the pundits are getting a bit strong on this. They're saying it's going to be a record year, but one rain doesn't make a record year, unfortunately. So we've got to start. So that's the main thing. We can get it in, and once you get it in and get it out the ground, well, you've done your part. But let's hope that there's a bit more rain around there once we manage to get it all in.
The rest is in the lap of the gods once it's through the ground, isn't it? But I had a rumour up there. It was that wet there at Peterborough and Jamestown. You were growing rice. So what's going on now?
Not that wet.
Well, let's have a look back to last round of matches. We'll check out round 7 of Northern Areas footy. And look, let's start with the major upset now. These guys are just flat out a tipster's nightmare, Oaroo. They knocked off the top side, Broughton Mundura, the week before. They come up against BMW, who were then the bottom side, and go down to them.
Takes a bit of working out, doesn't it? But look, we're perhaps underselling BMW a little bit there because they struggled early in the season, and then suddenly they've got some players back through. Like they were, some of them were on sickness leave, and once they got those back, they were look a different side altogether. And I reckon that they're right in it now, and that probably Oaroo, we always say, are very hard to beat on their home deck, which is where they played Broughton Mundura. But this one was up at Melrose, I think it was Melrose or Wilmington.
Yes, yeah, Melrose. Yep,
Melrose. Yeah. So that's a big advantage for BMW then, because I know that it looked like rain over there, but I don't think they had anything very much. So that meant that the game was pretty good. Their back line is functioning. BMW's back line is functioning very well with Nick McCullum, who has gone back into the back line after having played a few seasons up forward, and then you've got Jackson Cumnick's playing good footy for him. Josh Robinson, he had a bit of a problem. He got concussed in it, but he's been playing well too. So, look, they're starting to put it together, and after the break, they'll probably should be able to notch some more wins there with Alec Kanga being able to lead them from the front.
Yes, he'll be going around this weekend for Northern Areas. They'll be glad to have him in the Nutrient Ag Solutions Cup team. But what about my man, Tyson Christofferson? He kicked two goals, Kanga 2, Taylor 2, Williams 2. They had a host of guys who contributed on the scoreboard. Hughes, the only multiple goal kicker for Oaroo. But, Kanga, best man on the ground. So he's in good nick ahead of the association stuff this weekend.
Oh, a really good footballer, Alec. And he's great value in the representative games, and great to see that they're prepared to put themselves up.
Yeah. All right, Spud, here it is. Jamestown Peterborough. They went out against Southern Flinders with one goal in mind.
Not again.
Oh, no. Yeah. I thought this was behind us, Spud.
Yeah, that's probably the most disappointing thing, but I know that they probably are missing a key forward. Henry Moore is still not there. And look, if you score a goal in a quarter, you know, and you manage to get four goals, and Southern Flinders only got seven, you'd say that's pretty good effort. But I don't reckon Chris Stacey'd be all that thrilled with the fact that they could only score one in the third quarter, and they managed to get a few points. So they managed to get another goal with the other six shots that they hadn't that went through for behinds, but that's their big problem at the moment is being able to get the goals on the board. I think their work rate around the ball, what I've seen, has been good. They've got some younger players there. Well, they're not so young now. They've probably been around for 3 or 4 years now, And they're starting to get plenty of it. But the key thing is that if those players get the ball, they want it to go into the forward line and not come rushing out at 100 mile an hour so that all that work is undone. So that's what they'll be looking to do after the break is getting more forward pressure on sides, get some scoreboard pressure on them, and then I think it'll look a different side altogether.
Yeah, no doubt, mate. But Brock Grayson, probably best for Jamestown, Peterborough, Max Vormo and Daniel Clark. For the record, Henry Hall was the goal kicker for the Maggies, whereas Joel Amjurg Pedersen, I'll try and get it right and speak English. Joel's been a good player for a while now. He's kicked four goals in this game, and Ballantyne was named best on ground for Southern Flinders, only kicked the one goal, but in conditions like that, he set up plenty of others, I believe.
Yeah, see, that's the difference, isn't it, where they've got two there that can score goals, and there's more than that, actually. But they certainly have got more avenues through to goal, and that's what Jamestown Peterborough need to work on, is that they can sort of get, first of all, a focal point up there, and then you get other players come into it, and so you get your scoreboard pressure.
Yep. Now, Broughton Mundurra off of a loss at home, never a good time to get him. Crystal Brook drew the short straw. They headed down to take on a grumpy Eagles lineup who, after the first quarter, they led by 19 points at quarter time, kicked 5-2 in that opening term, and you thought, yep, how far the Eagles? But credit to Crystal Brook, the Chooks stuck at it, and in the end, they only went down by 19 points. So good game of footy this one, and the Eagles lucky to get home.
Yeah, Crystal Brook are a side that are on the move too, because they started slowly and now they're starting to get a few players back. Braden Kirk is back from Adelaide playing for them, and with Luke Capitola, Nathan Lambert, they're key players. They're sort of starting to look a little bit ominous as far as even making the four. Whereas Broughton Mundurra, well, they've had still got a heap of players out, and they had about 7 or 8 out when they played Oraru. But like you go with what you've got. But that's sort of not going to hurt them that much. They still sort of sit on top. They've had some pretty big wins there. The first time they played Oraru, they had a massive percentage boost there. So it doesn't hurt for them to lose a couple, but. Crystal Brook can come away and think, well, hey, we're not that far off of the top side.
Good point. And that's a look at last round of matches. Quick check of the ladder as it sits before the break. So it's pretty simple ladder looking at it. Broughton Mundurra on top along with Southern Flinders 6-1. So only percentage separating them. Oraru stuck in the middle there, 3-4. So they're third on the ladder. And then we've got a log jam towards the bottom. Crystal Brook, BMW, Jamestown, Peterborough, all have had 2 wins. So everyone's had a loss, everyone's had a win, just the way we like it.
Oh, look, it's a very interesting Premiership table, and it's good to see it like that. So, like, every side now has got a chance of playing in the finals, but you've got to be able to do it in the second half of the season. That's when the important stuff comes to the front.
Spot on, mate. Now, Nutrient Ag Solutions Cup this weekend at Port Broughton. Broughton Mundurra doing the hosting there. And just had a look at the senior team. It's been posted on the Facebook page. And Tom Button has been named skipper, the Broughton Mundurra man. And there are some big names in amongst this team. Joel Amjurg Pedersen, as I mentioned before, from Southern Flinders, he's in. Zeke Kay is in. From Jamestown, Peterborough, Henry Hall is made the side, which should please you, Spud. Matt White is also in the side, but big names. Alec Kanger is in. Nick Pearce is in. Luke Bowman is in. Jacob Acker is in. Lockie Doling, youngster, under 21. He's in. There's 1, 2. There's 6 under 21s in this team, Spud. It's a good mix.
Yeah, well, I think you'll find that. I did help set that up many years ago now. And I think that we put it in there that you had to have a certain number of under 21.
Yep.
I don't mind that idea because some people don't like it because of the fact that you could be keep your, they, you know, if you have to play an under 21, maybe they get in there on default. But it's good experience for them. And as long as you've got those experienced players, as you've mentioned, Alec Kanga, Nick Pearce, they are the people that will be able to have the experience there. And you, who knows what you get out of youngsters. Sometimes, you know, they mightn't have played association football before, but you put them up there and they really gel to it really quickly. And so, therefore, they give you a great account of what they of themselves on the day. And that's all we really look for. Very hard to pick winners in this sort of a competition because you're only playing a reduced game, two halves of 20 minutes, I reckon it is, 20 minutes plus time on. It's a team that bounces out the blocks. Sometimes, you know, they get a score on the board early and it's very hard then to pick it back. So, should be a really great weekend. Northeastern and Adelaide Plains, York Peninsula all have strong sides there. So it should be a great day's footy down at Broughton, and looking forward to seeing how we go as our association there.
Spot on, mate. Northern Areas will kick the Jew off the ground at 9:45 a.m. in the first game with the under-17s at Port Broughton. Of course, we don't know what round two brings because it depends on who the winners of the first two games are. So you've got York Peninsula first up there. And then, of course, the seniors will take centre stage. And I believe that happens from about 1 o'clock.
That's right, yep. Yep, so, you've got to win that first one because it's only the winners that get to play off for the big prize. So you lose that first one where you're playing for third or fourth. So very important that you try and get the first one and then see what happens.
Yep, all right. Well, Nutrien Ag Solutions Cup, we'll wrap that up next week and have a look at how Northern Areas go. Spud, enjoy the weekend, mate. Long weekend. Her Madge, the Queen, still celebrating 70 years of dominating the airwaves. Well, Spud, not quite 70 years dominating the cropping scene up there around Jamestown, Peterborough. But I'm looking forward to your Diamond Jubilee, mate, or Platinum, or whatever it's called, when the time comes, Spud.
Oh, I don't think I'll see that. I'm sure I'm going to be pinching off before that.
Enjoy the footy this weekend, mate. Good stuff.
Thanks, Jason. See you later.